Let us discuss on the life of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and also Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna. So let us pray to that Almighty Vishnu who invented this tree in different time in India. Yasya smarana matrena janma samsara bandhanat vimuchyate namastashmai vishnave prabhavishnave. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. We all know the Indian history proved it again and again, and the Indians, they all believe that the God made a promise that whenever there will be decline of righteousness and the origin of the unrighteousness, he will come to protect the humanity. Yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata. So that was the promise of the God, and we have seen again and again he is coming. He, the God, has given more reason why he is coming. In the same chapter in the Bhagavad Gita, he mentioned in the fourth chapter, he said, Paritranaya sadhunam vinashayacha duskritam. These are the two main. Then, dharma samsthapanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge. He is coming down, adventing again and again. So this is the point that we should remember. So the narrowness, sectarianness should not be there. It is the promise of the God. Again and again he is coming. In the different form, in different places, at different times. So that is the main thing. Dharma samsthaparnathaya sambhavami yuge yuge. So once only God has come, and that is the end of it, and he is not coming down back again, not like that. So paritranaya sadhunam, complete protections of the pious and destruction of the evildoers. Sadhunam, the sadhu means pious people, good people. And who can be considered as good people? We can understand, generally, that these are the things if the people are doing, performing, thinking, they are good people. And in one word we can say, one who is not harming in any way, creating problem for others, and at the same time, he is ever ready to help others, concern for others, is a good person. Along with that, the faith in the existence of God, the faith in the existence of the Almighty, and that is there, he is a good person. So this is in the Bhagavad Gita, we find that he is coming. And it is now that Sri Chaitanya and Sri Ramakrishna, both are incarnation of God. Sri Chaitanya advented in 18th February 1486 in Nadia, Bengal. Sri Ramakrishna advented in 18th February 1836. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came 18 February 1486 and Sri Ramakrishna came 18 February 1836. Exactly 350 years afterwards, Sri Chaitanya was 350 years older than Sri Ramakrishna. But so very common, so many common things we find that is very, very interesting, and we will see in their life and in their philosophy and in their way of handling things. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's father was Jagannath Mishra, a very pious and educated Brahmin. And the mother was Shachi Devi, a full of devotion lady, full of devotion they used to call her. So that is the family. And Sri Ramakrishna's father, Sudhiram Chattopadhyaya, he was also considered a very, very pious man. Wherever he used to live and used to go, people used to respect him. And he was considered a very spiritually uplifted, higher person. And his mother, Chandramati Devi, he was loved by all for her simplicity and purity. Now, we find that God is promising when there will be problem, when there is the dharma in problem, then only I will come. What happened actually at the time of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or at the time of Sri Ramakrishna that the God had to come? At the time of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the socio-political and religio-cultural condition was in a very bad shape in India. The Muslim king Bahlol Lodi captured Delhi in 1451, and the Lodi dynasty ruled till 1526. In First Panipat War, in 21st April 1526, Zahir ud-Din Muhammad Babur defeated the Lodis and established his rule. Babur's descendant, Jalaluddin Muhammad Akbar, fought the second Panipat in 5th November 1556 and ruled till 1605, that means almost 49 years. Then Bengal, though was a free state under the rule of Shah dynasty, which began in 1442 with Nasiruddin Mahmud Shah. At the time of Sri Chaitanya's birth, the ruler of Bengal was Jalaluddin Fateh Shah, and when he gave up his body, it was Nasiruddin Mahmud. So all through we find the rules of the Islam. As it always happened, the vanquished race lose everything under the pressure of the conqueror. Pages of history are full with torture, murder, rape, forceful conversion. Along with the atrocities of the ruling race, the so-called Hindu religious leaders, in the name of purity of religion, tortured general masses and women. It is said that there were only two options open for the general masses, either die or get yourself converted into Islam. That was very peculiar. In many of the stories we find, the soldiers, Muslim soldiers, they used to come and they used to touch the hand of a Hindu lady, and the villagers, including their family members, including her family members, just to take her and leave her at their door. Why? Because she has been touched by some other one. They lost the valor. They lost the self-confidence, self-respect. So that was the picture. Now, this was the social condition. You can understand the economical condition. You can understand the religious condition. And at that time, again and again, it has been said in different places, the most difficult people, the torturers, was our own people, as so-called pandits. The outcasting was so common, and sometimes the fun they used to make, that one person, he was a so-called leader of the village. Every time he used to go and see it for the judgment, you have made this the mistake, so you are outcasted. You have made this mistake, so you are outcasted. He used to come and boast after coming back home. He used to boast before his wife. I have outcasted this person, I have outcasted that person. One after another, the villagers, they were outcasted. Now, where they will go? They used to go to the Islam, they used to convert themselves into the Muslim. The moment they become Muslim, then they are allowed, because they immediately used to become the rulers. So obviously, the lost family, it is said, is not, I don't know whether it is history true or not, they said the last family he outcasted came back and boasted before his wife, I have outcasted the last family of the village. Then the wife very quietly said, you have outcasted or you have become outcasted. Because now they are in a caste, they are in a group, you are the only person. So that was the peculiar condition. Recently also we always find that was the Chaitanya's time. At that time, the time was ripe for the God to keep his promise. So he came as Sri Chaitanya. Exactly 350 years after, the ruler was changed. Instead of the sultans, came the British, and the torture became more intense. In the name of providing education, the Britishers planned to uproot the lifeline of the Indians, that is Dharma. That is the life of Indians, Swami Vivekananda is telling, it is Dharma. Where the life of the Indians are kept, it is Dharma. Quoting a story, he used to say, it is the Dharma. You touch their economy, they won't say anything. You capture them politically, they won't say anything. But the moment you touch their religion, they will rise up and fight. So that way, they were trying to destroy the very subtle way, the Dharma. In 1835, in the British Parliament, the one of their lords, after the survey in India, he came back and he was giving the report. If we have to rule India for eternity, we have to change their religion through our education. So Macaulay policy was adopted for education. And there every time they used to say, everything that you see in your country, in your society, in your religion, are wrong, wrong and wrong. Everything has been given by us, given by us, and given by us. By hearing like that constantly in everywhere, so obviously they started believing that we were not having anything. It is only the Britishers, they have given us everything. So that they lost the confidence, the once a person and the society lose their confidence, there remain nothing. So the hundreds of missionaries were very busy to convert, and they were successful to a great extent. And we find the educated class lost faith in Hinduism and got either converted or tried to start a new path. They were trying to adjust themselves, and we find that it was cropping up in different places. Brahma Samaj, particularly in the eastern India, is an example. And whatever they said, they accepted it and philosophized, and they started a new path without realizing what is going to happen afterwards. Why not go and see, find out what is the truth in our own religion? Because that type of confidence was not there, and realization of God was not there, hence that complete faith in the existence of God also was not there. Now the Britishers divide and rule policy started bearing fruits. The religious divisions, we know, and provinces were divided, the caste division, linguistic divisions, Indians were divided in small groups. They were fast losing respect for their past, losing confidence for the future. They were just surviving, observing this pathetic condition. Swami Vivekananda afterwards lamented, "Lo, the descendant of the rishis have become next door neighbor to brute." Again the great God came to save the dharma and to make the human human. This time he came in the form of Sri Ramakrishna. Sri Chaitanya's name was Bishambar. It was given after calculation that he is the power of Vishnu. And Sri Ramakrishna's name was Gadadhar. He was also Vishnu. Both of them were very, very energetic. When they were very young, they used to play and they used to create a lot of problems for the neighbors. But somehow the neighbors, they used to love them very much. We find so common thing. The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also used to go and bathe in the Hugli, the Ganga there, and creating problem for those elderly people after the holy deep, when they are trying to concentrate and pray, the young boys under the leadership of Chaitanya, the Vishambar, they used to go and jump in the water, splashing water on their faces and body, and they used to be very, very angry. The same thing in the life of Sri Ramakrishna too. The tremendous energy manifested and intelligent. Whatever they heard, they immediately remembered. Here we can say the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, at the age of 10, he became a very famous the scholar. At the age of 20, he was accepted by everyone. And even he was a Tarthik, and he defeated the famous scholars. So each and everyone accepted him as a very great scholar. He had his own school, he used to teach. Here, Sri Ramakrishna is different. Sri Ramakrishna never attended any school and never learned that way, that so-called education. And of course, this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was named Bishambar, and then the village women, they used to call him because he had a complex, that very fair complex, so they gave the name Gaur. And as because he used to say Hari Hari again and again, so Gaur Hari, that was his, the name was given by the villagers. He was born under a neem tree, so his mother used to call him Nimai. So Bishambar and then Gaur Hari, Nimai, then afterwards Chaitanya, this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And in the childhood itself, they had expressed the spiritual experiences. The one day, the baby Chaitanya, as the mothers, they used to decorate them with many the jewelries, and he was alone. Then a person came, a thief, and he wanted to take the boy somewhere in a secluded place so that he will take out all those jewelries and go. And the baby Chaitanya also very willingly went on his lap, keeping the boy on his shoulder. He started moving the tail. But very peculiarly, again and again, he started coming back to the same place. He forgot the route, how to go. And he was coming back again and again. After three times, he understood something very wrong. So he left the boy, and immediately he saw the path and he left. That was a miracle happened in the life of Sri Chaitanya. And in the life of Sri Ramakrishna, when he was going to Vishalakshi, we know that in the Vishalakshi, when he heard that the villagers, the ladies, they are chatting among themselves, not about God, and all something about else, they immediately to teach them that as you are going to a temple, you are going to a particular purpose, you should prepare your mind with that, constantly thinking about God. And he went into samadhi thinking about the Vishalakshi. Vishalakshmi means the goddess. This is Durga, this is the Shakti. So this Vishalakshi, still that temple is there. And then all became attentive to him, and they were chanting the name of God, and then he came back. And also, we find that in the Shivaratri, Sri Ramakrishna decorated himself because the villagers wanted and as a Shiva. And this time in our izin, in the editorial I have mentioned this. The Shiva, the moment they completed the decoration, he went into the trance and he was standing on the stage as Shiva. They could not see the play, but they saw the original Shiva, living Shiva, in the person of the Gadadhar. And this in the different type of experiences. When the Pandits used to discuss Nimai, the young boy, he used to go listen to them, and sometimes he used to comment that you are making a mistake like this, it should be like this. And in the life of Sri Ramakrishna also we find the same history. And one day when the Tirthi means he used to go to different pilgrimage. He came to Nadia and he stayed as a guest in the Chaitanya's father's house. And he prepared food for the Vishnu and offered it, closed his eyes and was praying to God to come and take that food. Chaitanya came, Mahaprabhu came and took away that. Again the father said, please, you please prepare again because my son has made a mistake. He prepared again, he offered again. Again Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and took that. Third time he understood, this is the God, he is offering the food. The God is accepting in the form of Chaitanya. We find the same thing in the life of Ramakrishna also. His father, Khudiram Chattopadhyay, prepared a garland for his own personal deity, Raghuveera. And when he was putting it in the Raghuveera, kept on Raghuveera and was meditating, then his son, Gadadhar, went, took that garland, put it on him, and he was calling his father, look at me, I have decorated myself with that garland, and am I not looking good? His father opened his eyes, remembered that he saw that vision that Vishnu himself is giving that assurance, I will come as your son. So this is Vishnu. It is said in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Roditi sa dinam prapya, prabuddha rajani mukhe, divasa ayam iti praha, jana uchuriyam shapa. Rodisi sa dinam prapya. When the daytime, he is to cry, Chaitanya. He is to pray, he is to cry in such a way that people used to wonder, is it possible for one to cry with such a longing for God? We go to temple, we meditate, we offer food to God, and there it ends. We come back, we attend to some other things. But when the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came back from his pilgrimage and he was full with devotion to God, the Krishna, and he used to cry, Krishna, Krishna, and Krishna, again and again, day and night, roditi, he used to weep, he used to cry, dinam prapya, prabuddha rajani mukhe, and in the night also, again he used to cry, dibaso ayamiti praha. So where is the day, where is the night? He never could keep any account. Is this the day, is it the night? Constantly he used to cry, jana uchuriyam shapa. And those who have read the biography of Sri Ramakrishna, we know how. It was 350 years before Sri Ramakrishna, the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we have not seen. But there are many people at the time of Sri Ramakrishna, which is only 200 years before. And this, Sri Ramakrishna, he used to cry, cry and cry in such a way, it was unthinkable. And he himself said, I never knew when the day came and when the night came. He used to sometimes ask people, is it the daytime or nighttime? He used to go into some that trance, constantly forgetting the all surroundings. And that way, both of them are teaching us, if you want to realize God, you have to be attentive, you have to be constantly put your mind only in that. We can understand now how difficult it is to realize God. And both of them, Sri Ramakrishna used to say that when I used to meditate, even the snakes used to come, used to cross his body, and he never felt. Birds used to come and sit on his that matted hair, and Sri Ramakrishna never could understand the birds are there, and birds also never could feel that they are sitting on something living. As a human being, that is the roditi sa dinam prapya prabuddha rajani mukhe. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took initiation from Madhavendra Puri, and he took sannyas to Keshav Bharati. Both are under the same, the Dasanami Sampradaya. Puri, Bharati, they are the three groups are there, they are under this. Puri, Bharati, I think the Giri also. And Totapuri, he gave the sannyas to Sri Ramakrishna. So Swami Vivekananda commented, it seems that our Madhavendra Puri, Ishar Puri, Madhavendra Puri, and the Totapuri of the Puri Sampradaya, Puri Sampradaya has something very special for this Bengal. So the great personalities, they are coming and accepting the traditions, parampara from the Puri Sampradaya. In Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and also in Sri Ramakrishna, we find the special thing, that is the combination of the knowledge and bhakti, devotion. The devotion and knowledge, that is very, very special. And at the same time, karma, the work. And when these three are coming, obviously the concentration, as just now we were discussing about the concentration, and to practice the concentration, that is the yoga, the meditation, constantly keeping the mind in God. And this is the jnana and bhakti. What is the jnana? What is the knowledge? The God is the only existence and nothing else. Whatever else you see is the manifestation of the same God. The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu could see nothing else but the God, manifestation of God. Sri Ramakrishna afterwards said, he could never see anything else but Krishna. And that is why he used to go and jump in the ocean. He used to live in the Puri, in the Orisha. And he used to go and jump in the ocean, not considering that it is a water and the ocean, he may carry it out, he may die. He used to see the Krishna standing over there, he used to go and jump in the water. People used to go and take him back. He was so much totally possessed with that. And that was the devotion, complete devotion. And at the same time we find Sri Ram in knowledge also, God is in everything. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Sri Ramakrishna, both they saw God in everything and expressed that in their day-to-day life. And that is why we find that even the low-caste people who were shunned by the so-called pandits, the religious teachers, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu loved them so much. And Sri Ramakrishna also used to love so much. The Sri Ramakrishna in the beginning of his life, we find that he accepted the bhiksha, the alms that a Brahmin should accept from a lady as his bhiksha mata. That was a low caste lady. And also he accepted the pujari, the post of a pujari, and that also the temple also was built by so-called low caste lady, Rani Rashmani. And we find in Sri Ramakrishna's life so many people are coming. Even the Chinu Shakari, he used to eat from the hand of the Chinu Shakari. Being a Brahmin boy in those days, even today, people cannot think of. But Sri Ramakrishna, without any hesitation, he used to take food. Why? He is a devotee. And the devotees had no caste. He used to say, Bhaktir Jatnai. As a devotee has no caste because their devotion has given them that much height, the status. So they have no caste, only one caste, that is the devotion. So they are the children of God. They are the faithfuls and they are belong to one group, not the Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, nothing. So that was Chaitanya and also in Sri Ramakrishna. In the Chaitanya also we find the Muslims are coming and accepting him as a guru, and he is also accepting them as the disciple. Bandetam Krishna Chaitanyam Matri Bhakta Shiromanim Pralapya Mukha Sangharshi Madhudyane Lalasa Yaha. Chaitanya Charitamrita, there also in the 19th chapter, it says, and that is also so common between these two, the great respect for the mother who has given me birth, the great respect for her. Both them are sannyasins. Even then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took the permission of his mother. Mother was crying. In the beginning she was not ready to give the permission. Chaitanya went on praying to her, please give me permission to take the sannyas. I will not survive over here. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu married the first Lakshmi Devi. That was also just like Sri Ramakrishna was choosing his own wife. Similarly, the Chaitanya went to bathe in the Ganga, and there he saw that Lakshmi Devi. And afterwards, he looked at the Lakshmi Devi, smiled at her, and Lakshmi immediately understood and offered her pranam to. Then they got married. But though unfortunately, she passed away by snake bite. And as because the Chaitanya's mother ordered, almost compelled him to marry second time, so the Vishnu Priya, he married that lady. But that lady was also completely dedicated. And she lived a wonderful life. And almost everyone, the biographers of Sri Chaitanya are silent about the Vishnu Priya. But if you go even to that Nadia, that room is still there where she used to live, quietly, alone, continuously taking the name of God. And that is the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, just like Sri Ramakrishna, from distance is to take care about her. Because he knew that he has to take care about his own wife. So he was not that way careless about his own wife. So this is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Sri Ramakrishna, we know that Sri Ramakrishna was living with Ma Saradamani Devi. But that was a wonderful divine couple. They were constantly thinking about God. And both they were living together, praying together, and proceeding together towards the Godhead. And here it says, Vandetam Krishna Chaitanyam Matri Bhakta Shiromanim, the highest among the devotees of the mother. The mother is considered as the highest goddess. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he got the permission from his mother, he went round with great reverence, took her dust from the feet of his mother, then only he left. And constantly he remembered her. And sometimes he used to come back from the distance, he used to see the mother is all right, like this. And Sri Ramakrishna, we find him that Sri Ramakrishna was so much respectful for his mother. When he went to Vrindavan, there he got the attraction that I must live in the Vrindavan itself. You know, in the history. Then immediately I remembered my own mother. I came back. I couldn't stay in Vrindavan even because my mother is here. I have to be near her. And he used to go and inquire every day, how are you, mother? Mother is to live in the Dakshineshwar under his care. Though he used to be intoxicated almost constantly every moment with the mother's name, divine mother, Kali. But even then he never forgot. Once only he wanted to, just as a fun, as a boy, he dressed as a sannyasi and came to his mother and showed that to his mother. Look, I have dressed like a sannyasi. And mother told, never come like this, Chandramani Devi said. I cannot bear it. It is impossible. So when he took sannyasa, he didn't wear the Gerua cloth because his mother was there. With the Gerua clad Sri Ramakrishna, maybe it would have been very difficult for her to bear. So Sri Ramakrishna never took the Gerua. Just exactly with the white cloth he used to be. That much respect for the mother, for both of them. And Pralappa Mukhasangarshi, they used to rub their faces on the floor and crying for God. Every day, every moment, after moment, time is passing. Then what will happen to me? Oh my God, you have not come, you have not revealed, I have not realized you. Both there, the intense prayer was like that, same. And once Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Ami Advaita Chaitanya Nityananda in one. Advaita Chaitanya Nityananda. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he took the sannyas and then he wanted to display what a sannyasi should be in the truest form. And you can understand that was the time, the Muslim rule. So obviously there was no opportunity to show anything else. So he was very, very strict in the sannyasi life. One of his disciples went and accepted a good rice from a lady. And that was cooked. When that was offered to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they thought he'll be very happy after a long time getting a good, nice, boiled, cooked rice. Immediately he inquired, where you went for bhiksha, for your begging? Then he said, she is also a very great devotee and she has given this for you. Immediately Chaitanya turned that and asked her, you should not be with me. Go and stay somewhere else. Practice austerity. Purify yourself. Then only you come. Why? Because sannyasi should not have any sort of luxury. why you are thinking that white rice, good rice, whatever it comes from, whoever gives that, that you should accept. Why you went particularly to her to get this good rice? No, you should not. So that way, Chaitanya was so strict. They used to say, his control on the tongue was so much. Even the people who used to pour the sugar on his tongue used to remain dry. Can you imagine that? So that was Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And we find in the life of Sri Ramakrishna also, some people, they used to be there. One mother used to send people to serve him. That was the speciality. He forgot about his food when he was to meditate. So one person came, even sometimes he used to beat at his back with the stick to bring his consciousness back to his body to feed him. That man used to forcefully feed him. And that was the tremendous control. He used to live like that. But one thing we find, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he never accepted the women, but the Sri Ramakrishna accepted them. In the life of Sri Ramakrishna, constantly we find how a few days back, in one of our program, the one of our devotees, she was speaking about the contribution of in the women in the life of Sri Ramakrishna, that we find that he accepted Mother Kali, Goddess Kali, as his own personal deity, accepted Bhairavi Brahmani, accepted Ma Saradamani Devi, accepted the food from that low-caste lady, that Dhoni Kamarini. So all this, one again and again. Why? Afterwards, his disciple, Swami Vivekananda, said that a bird cannot fly without the two wings. See, if we have to, our society should grow, both men and women should be equally educated and strong and advanced in thinking. So that was Sri Ramakrishna. Now, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu brought the name only, without anything. Go on repeating the name of Hari. He sent out the Nityananda. Nityananda became the Abadhut. He didn't take the sannyas. He married. He stayed in the household. And he was Abadhut. Abadhuts are allowed to do whatever they like. They are beyond any social rule. Nityananda and Chaitanya, they were very close. And this Nityananda, he used to go to house to house. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, go to house, ask people wherever you meet them, only to repeat the Harinama. Only Harinama, that will do. So how the missionary work? Because in those days it was impossible. Because they lost the faith, they were afraid of the Brahminism. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was a Brahmin. And the moment they will call him, the other society, how they will think? So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sent Nityananda and his associates, and he went, only said, you need not to do anything, only repeat Harinama, that will do. So Hare Krishna became a famous mantra that was given to each and everyone. And Chaitanya used to say, just repeat this and God will save you. And that way Hinduism was saved. Hundreds of people, they used to come and gather and they used to move. And they became very devoted. Some of them, they developed the spirituality. They came in close contact with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna, much afterwards, suddenly he saw two persons and he said, I saw you in the procession of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And who are those? One is Balaram Bosu, another is Master Mahashaya. The Master Mahashaya is Sri Ma. He was one of that. Sri Ramakrishna could see them that way. The one person who was telling, is it true that our past lives are there? I don't know. But these are the evidences in the life of Sri Ramakrishna. And as I believe Sri Ramakrishna, I believe that there are. So I cannot give you the reasons why I believe, and I believe in every word of Sri Ramakrishna. When he said that, there are two persons I saw, and that is Balaram Bose in the company of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And we find Sri Ramakrishna. He was a tantric, they used to call him in that way. And he was a worshipper of goddess Kali. But when he used to chant the name of Krishna, hundreds used to be charmed with that. They used to come in hundreds. They used to come days after days. There was no time for Sri Ramakrishna to take little food or rest. They used to come in groups after groups to see, and they declared, wonderful person who die and again come to life, who die and again come to life. More ar bache, amon lok esheche. As he used to die and leave again, because he used to go into the trance and again come back to normalcy, and he used to go on taking this name again, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's. He never said that, why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's name? I should introduce in my own way. No. He understood that this is the simple way, simplest way. For the ordinary people, most ordinary people who cannot spend time and who don't have time to think also seriously, only to take the name of God will help them. Only believe it, that you are taking the name of God and you are becoming holy. That's all. So that was the movement Chaitanya Mahaprabhu brought, and he said, I am the three, Sri Chaitanya, and also Advaita and Nityananda. Advaita also spread that bhakti movement, Nityananda the same, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also. Here we find Sri Ramakrishna, he is giving everything to Ma Sharada Muni Devi, who was leaving after him just as a householder and giving the solace and encouragement to hundreds of householders, ordinary people. They never knew nothing about the religion. They had no time to practice or follow the austere path. They used to come to Mother. Mother used to say, only believe, Sri Ramakrishna, that will do. They are the great solace. So, Mother, at the same time, Sri Ramakrishna gave his all power into Swami Vivekananda. We know those stories. He entered into him. In one place, in the time of Ma Saradamani Devi, he said, I give you everything, including the Japamala, his beads, which he used to count the name of God that he gave at the feet of Mother. Shodashi Puja, it is coming again. After 1 or 2 months, this puja, that time, Paloharini Kali Puja, he performed and gave everything to Ma Sharadamani. That means the God gave that power, and also the same God gave the power to Vivekananda. So the three always sitting, they are not three, they are one. As Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, I am that Advaita Chaitanya Nityananda. And this way we find these two great personalities. At the time of the Sri Ramakrishna, they started disbelieving, and that went so deep. Even today, if you talk to the people, so-called educated people, immediately they will shun. They are ready to talk about anything except religion. They think it is just a very, very ordinary thing. Educated people should not discuss about religion. This is very peculiar. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu passed away on 14 June 1534. And Sri Ramakrishna, he passed away in 15th August 1886. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu left a legacy. He sent his great disciples, Rupa Sanatana, Jiva Goswami towards the north of India. And they went, they discovered the Vrindavan, and they established over there the Vaishnava movement. And he sent Advaita Nityananda in the eastern part of Bengal, eastern part of India, that is mainly in Bengal, centering the Nadia, they developed that Gaudiya Vaishnav cult. Of course, the history says these both groups, they started breaking because the Gaudiya Vaishnav and the Jiva Goswami, Rupa and Sanatana, their part, they could not come together. Anyway, that's a different thing, but the Vaishnav movement that took up the great force. Sometimes some people they say that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu never accepted Advaita. We cannot believe it. The Advaita Vedanta, that God is in everything, that was there. But at the same time, God in everything, that's why it is not that everything is God, but God in everything. We have to understand that. And they say that the ocean, you cannot say all the waves are the ocean, but the waves belong to ocean. So jivas are nothing but the manifestation of God, but you cannot say the jivas are God. You have to see that manifestation only, then only. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that is another topic. Maybe tomorrow I will be going to the one devotee's house. I'm not disclosing because if there is a crowd, I don't know without her permission. So I'm going. That is also today the India is observing this, what's called Holi. And tomorrow also here in America people will be observing. Of course they will observe particularly in the vacation, that means time of Saturday or Sunday, maybe in the weekend they will observe. But the Holi means this discussion about the great personalities. I will try to explain Achinta Veda Avedavada. Achinta, unexplicable, Veda, division, Aveda, non-division, Vada. They say it was actually developed by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What is there? What is the difference between the Advaita? But about Sri Ramakrishna, it is very clear. Ma Saradamani Devi said, your guru, that means Sri Ramakrishna, is an Advaitin. You all are Advaitin. So we are devotee, we are karmi, and we are at the same time jnani, discriminating, studying, and we are meditating also. So this four combination that was given by Sri Ramakrishna, and it was actually manifested and gave a shape by Swami Vivekananda and then his other direct disciples, and now it has taken a huge shape, a huge banyan tree in the form of Ramakrishna Mott and Ramakrishna Mission, and they call it Ramakrishna Movement. And here in the Ramakrishna Movement, what is this? They go and tell only one thing: you are divine, try to understand it. And we are here to help you to manifest it. We are also trying to manifest, you also manifest that divinity, that Advaitin ideology. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also said, only take the name of Hari and please believe there is God. And if you take His name, He will take care of you. This is the wonderful, this life of Sri Chaitanya and Sri Ramakrishna. Let us offer our pranam to these both, Sri Ramakrishna and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Yasya smarana matrena janma samsara bandhanat vimuchyate namastashmai Vishnave Prabha Vishnave. Om Shanti. 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 Hari Om.